Okay, dito naman sa anong video ito, ang pag-uusapan natin ay sa Unit 2, Module 2 tayo. Ang Module 2, ang itatakil natin is all about electromagnetic spectrum. Pero sa video ito, ang pag-uusapan muna natin is the development of electromagnetic wave theory. Paano ba nabuo ito? Sino-sino yung mga scientist na contributor sa pagkabuo nitong itinatawag natin na electromagnetic wave theory? For our introduction, in Module 1, you have learned about the interrelationship between electricity and magnetism. You were able to discover how electric field could create magnetic field and vice versa. This module, you will learn about the different regions of the electromagnetic spectrum or the members of the family of the EM wave spectrum. This module will lead you to understand how electromagnetic waves transport energy. It also consists of activities that will enrich your understanding on the application of electromagnetic waves in our everyday living and consequently, how these waves affect living things and the environment. So, at the end of the Module 2, you will be able to answer the following questions. How do the regions in the electromagnetic spectrum differ in terms of wavelength, frequency, and energy? So, how do the different types of electromagnetic waves become relevant to people and environment? And what are the consequent effects of electromagnetic waves? So, for our competencies or objectives, trace the development of the electromagnetic theory. O, ito na nga po yun, yung first lesson natin ngayon. Yan ang number one muna na i-achieve natin is to trace the history of the development of the electromagnetic theory. Describe how electromagnetic wave is produced and propagated. So, sa mga sunod po yan na video lesson. And compare the relative wavelengths, frequencies, and energies of the different regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. Yung sunod pong video lesson, ito ng number 3 ito, ma-achieve na natin ito. So, cite examples of practical applications of the different regions of EM waves. So, what are the uses in our everyday living of the different kinds of EM waves or the different members of the EM waves family? Explain the effects of electromagnetic radiation on living things and the environment. Send text message to somebody today. Or did you send a message in a messenger? Or have you ever tried cooking in a microwave oven? Did you know that these previously mentioned human activities make use of microwaves? A microwave carry energy and so with the other kinds of electromagnetic waves. But what are electromagnetic waves? These are the questions that we are going to answer in this module. How can these waves become useful to us? So kapakipakinabang pala itong iba't ibang member ng electromagnetic wave. For a start, let us learn how the study of electromagnetic waves came to be. So for our activity 1, how it came about. The objective of this first activity, the objectives are match the scientist with their contribution to the development of the electromagnetic theory. So we will be acquainted with the different scientists who contributed to the development of electromagnetic wave theory. And number 2 objective, make comic strips of the scientist's contribution. So for our materials, one white cartolina, marker pen, pencil with eraser, coloring materials. Simple lang po yung gagawin naman natin dito. So pag-aralan muna natin itong iba't ibang scientist na nandito. So for our timeline of electromagnetism and classical optics, 1801, Johann Reiter discovered UV radiation from the sun. And 1820, Hans Christian Oersted, a Danish physicist and chemist, united the separate sciences of electricity and magnetism. He develops an experiment in which he notices a compass needle is deflected from magnetic north when an electric current from the battery he was using was switched on and off, convincing him that magnetic fields radiate from all sides of a live wire, just as light and heat do, confirming a direct relationship between electricity and magnetism. He also observed that the movement of the compass needle to one side of the other depends upon the direction of the current. Following intensive investigations, he published his findings, proving that a changing electric current produces a magnetic field as it flows through a wire. The Oersted unit of magnetic induction is named for his contribution. The discovery of Hans Christian Oersted is accidental. When he was doing demonstration teaching on his students, he accidentally noticed that when he connected the wire or when he switched on and off the wire, there is a deflection in a compass or in a direction compass nearby the wire. So that is an accidental discovery. Picture ng ating mga scientists na nabanggit. So in 1820, André Marie Ampère, professor of mathematics at the École Polytechnique, a short time after learning of Oersted's discovery that a magnetic needle is acted on by a voltaic current, conducted experiments and published a paper in Annales de Chimie et de Physique, attempting to give a combined theory of electricity and magnetism. He showed that a coil of wire carrying a current behaves like an ordinary magnet and suggested that electromagnetism might be used in telegraphy. So he mathematically developed Ampere's law, describing the magnetic force between two electric currents. His mathematical theory explains known electromagnetic phenomena and predicts new ones. His laws of electrodynamics include the facts that parallel conductors current carrying in the same direction attract and those carrying currents in the opposite direction repel one another. So one of the first to develop electrical measuring techniques, he built an instrument utilizing a free moving needle. He built an instrument utilizing a free moving needle to measure the flow of electricity, contributing to the development of the so-called galvanometer. So si Andre Ampere pala po ang malaki din ang naitulong. So pero ang pinagbasehan niya is based on the discovery of Oersted. So continuation itong kay Andre Marie Ampere. So nakabuo din siya ng tinatawag na telegraphy. In 1821, he proposed a telegraphy system utilizing one wire per galvanometer to indicate each letter and reported experimenting successfully with such a system. However, in 1824, Peter Barlow reported its maximum distance was only 200 feet. So yung unang telegraphy na nabuo is only 200 feet. And to indicate, in 1821, he proposed a telegraphy system utilizing one wire per galvanometer to indicate each letter and reported experimenting successfully with such a system. However, in 1824, Peter Barlow reported its maximum distance was only 200 feet. So malapitan lang po yung unang nagawa na telegraphy. And so was impractical. So in 1826, he published the Memoir on the Mathematical Theory of Electrodynamic Phenomena, uniquely deduced from experience, containing a mathematical derivation of the electrodynamic force law, following Faraday's discovery of electromagnetic induction in 1831, Ampere agreed that Faraday deserved full credit for the discovery. So almost magkahawig pala yung discovery nito ni Faraday. Pero ang ampere po na unit is the unit of current. Ano po kaya may tinatawag tayo na ammeter. So when you say ampere, that is the unit of current. So the unit of current was credited to Andre Marie Ampere. So in 1821 again, Andre Marie Ampere pronounced his theory of electrodynamics, predicting the force that one current exerts upon another. And in 1826, George Simon Ohm stated his Ohm's law of electrical resistance in the journals of Schwieger and Poggendorf, and also published in his landmark pamphlet Die Galvanische Kette Mathematik Verbate in 1827. The unit Ohm, ito po yung symbol ng Ohm, of electrical resistance has named in his honor. Kaya pag ito nakita natin itong unit na to as Ohm, it is pertaining to resistance from surname of George Simon Ohm. So the Ohm's law was also formulated. So this is the formula for Ohm's law, that I, current, is equals to V over R. The V is voltage divided by the resistance. In 1831, Michael Faraday began experiments leading to his discovery of the law of electromagnetic induction. Though the discovery may have been anticipated by the work of Francisco Sandecesch, he then used this principle to construct the electric dynamo, the first electric power generator. He proposed that electromagnetic forces extended into the empty space around the conductor, but did not complete that work. Faraday's concept of lines of flux emanating from charged bodies and magnets provided a way to visualize electric and magnetic fields. That mental model was crucial to the successful development of electromechanical devices, which were to dominate the 19th century. His demonstrations that a charging magnetic field produces an electric field, mathematically modeled by Faraday's law of induction, would subsequently become one of Maxwell's equations. This consequently evolved in the generalization of field theory. So, the first generator was credited to Michael Faraday. At may kwento pa nga po nito na may isang government official noon na tinignan yung kanyang first electrodynamo, and ang sabi ni Michael Faraday, ang tanong niya ay, why are you going to tax my experiment? So na ngayon po nangyayari talaga na kinukuna na ng tax ang production ng electropo si Michael Faraday at ang kanyang setup, yung kanyang electromagnetic induction experiment. So in 1845, Michael Faraday discovered that light propagation in a material can be influenced by external magnetic fields, or the so-called Faraday effect. In 1855, James Clerk Maxwell submitted on Faraday's lines of force for publication, containing a mathematical statement of Ampere's circuital law relating the curl of a magnetic field to the electrical current at a point. In 1861, the first transcontinental telegraph system spans North America by connecting an existing network in the eastern United States to a small network in California by a link between Omaha and Carson City via Salt Lake City. So, dati po kung yung telegraph ay 200 feet lang ang napupuntahan, ito nagkaroon na ng first transcontinental telegraph system noong 1861. So, nagkaroon po ng development or ng improvement yung first discovery na telegraphy. In 1864, James Clerk Maxwell published his papers on a dynamical theory of the electromagnetic field. In 1865, James Clerk Maxwell published his landmark paper, A Dynamical Theory of the Electromagnetic Field, in which Maxwell's equations demonstrated that electric and magnetic forces are two complementary aspects of electromagnetism. He showed that the associated complementary electric and magnetic fields of electromagnetism travel through space in the form of waves at a constant velocity of 3 times 10 raised to 8. Ito pong 8 na to is, ano po ito, exponent. 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. This is the speed of light. He also proposes that light is a form of electromagnetic radiation and that waves of oscillating electric and magnetic fields travel through empty space at a speed that could be predicted from simple electrical experiment. So the electromagnetic wave po is related to light, because the speed of light is 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second or equivalent to 300,000 kilometer per second. So using available data, he obtains a velocity of 310,740,000 meter per second. Kapag meter po, pero kapag kinonvert natin yun sa kilometer, that is 300,000 kilometer per second. And it states this velocity is sonarly that of light. So parehas, halos related po sa light. That it seems we have a strong reason to conclude that light itself, including radiant heat and other radiations, if any, is an electromagnetic disturbance in the form of waves propagated through the electromagnetic field according to electromagnetic laws. In 1873, James Clerk Maxwell published a treatise on electricity and magnetism, which states that light is an electromagnetic phenomenon. Yon. Noong 1873 po, talagang lumabas na ng official findings itong si James Clerk Maxwell that light itself is considered as electromagnetic wave. In 1887, Heinrich Hertz invented a device for a production and reception of electromagnetic radio waves. His receiver consists of a coil with a spark gap. So ito po yung itsura nun, no? May gap, spark gap, tumatawid po yung spark, meaning ito po yung pasimula ng tinatawag natin na wireless communication, itong kay Heinrich Hertz na invention. So mayroong receiver at mayroong mag-transmit, transmitter and receiver. So in 1888, Heinrich Hertz demonstrated the existence of electromagnetic waves by building an apparatus that produced and detected UHF radio waves or microwaves in the UHF region. He also found that radio waves could be transmitted through different types of materials and were reflected by others. The key to radar, his experiments explain reflection, refraction, polarization, interference and velocity of electromagnetic waves. So sa discovery ito ni Heinrich Hertz, mas nabigyan ng linaw kung ano ba yung reflection, refraction, polarization, yung pagtatagpo, interference, and yung velocity or the speed of So si Heinrich Hertz, ang apelyado po yun na Hertz is ginagamit yan as unit of frequency. Ano po yung Hertz? Kaya pag sinabing, what is the unit of frequency? Ang symbol po yan is Hz or Hertz. And 1895, Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen discovers X-ray. So ito naman, related na po ito sa chemistry, physics and chemistry, yung discovery ni Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen na kung saan hindi niya ma-identify yung wave, yung ray na yon, kaya tinawag niya na X-ray, kumbaga unknown. Siguro pinangalan niya na lang sa kanya, ano po, Röntgen ray. So yun po, usable hanggang ngayon yung X-ray na yon sa medicine. Dito sa part na to, sa activity ito, match the scientists given below with their contribution. So we have 1 to 5 here, Ampere, Faraday, Hertz, Maxwell, Oersted. So here are the contribution. You're just simply going to write the letter in number 1, for example, what is the answer in number 1. And in number 2, using the information you gathered previously, make a concept web, comic strip or comic strips of the contributions of the following scientists. So itong limang scientists na to, gagawa nyo po ng concept web. And for our guide question, what new insights or learning did you get about our natural world? So, how did it change your view about light? Ilang concepts doon sa ano natin, electromagnetic waves. When you say electromagnetic waves are disturbances that transfer through field. And electromagnetic waves are transverse waves. Do not require a medium for transmission. When you say do not require even at vacuum. When you say vacuum, there is nothing. Kahit walang kalaman-laman vacuum na makaka-travel po ang electromagnetic wave. Ganyan po siya katindi ang EM wave. Hindi tulad ng ibang wave po, kailangan niya ng medium or kailangan niya ng daanan ng materials para makapag-transfer. Pero ang electromagnetic waves po, kahit sa vacuum, travel with the same speed in the absence of matter vacuum. And this speed is absolute. EM waves travel at constant speed of 300 million meter per second. Speed of light po yan. Kung kukunin nga natin sa scientific notation, we're just going to adjust 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Kaya 3 times 10 raised to 8 meter per second. Ang 8 po doon is the exponent of 10, power of 10. And are produced by accelerating electrons. Are combinations of electric and magnetic fields that oscillate perpendicular to each other and to the direction of the wave. And these are the scientists who did great contributions to the development of electromagnetic wave theory. We have André Marie Ampère, demonstrated the magnetic effect based on the direction of current. Michael Faraday, he formulated the principle behind electromagnetic induction or the discovery of the generator and motor. Heinrich Rudolf Hertz, he showed experimental evidence of electromagnetic waves and their link to light. By means of Hertz, it is being connected, that electromagnetic wave is connected to light. James Clerk Maxwell, he contributed in developing equations showing the relationship of electricity and magnetism. So, James Clerk Maxwell just mathematically expressed all the ideas of the previous scientists who contributed to the development of electromagnetic wave. So, Hans Christian Oersted, he showed how a current carrying wires behaves like a magnet. So, may mga kasunod pang scientists doon kina Heinrich Hertz, kina nakadiscovery ng X-ray. Papunta po yung tinatawag na wireless communication. Kaya kung bakit meron tayo ngayong cellphone na nai-enjoy natin, na bit-bit natin kahit saan, that is a part of the development of electromagnetic wave theory. Okay, for our assessment question, we have one question here. He contributed in developing equations showing the relationship of electricity and magnetism. Sino po yung gumawa ng mathematical equation? Sino kaya? Okay, that is James Clerk Maxwell. So for our next video lesson, we are going to tackle the members of the electromagnetic spectrum. We have the gamma ray, x-ray, ultraviolet, infrared, microwave, radio wave. In this graph, we are going to explain this graph on the next video lesson. Okay, maraming salamat po.